Yo, what up? It's your boy Black with Black TV, where we give you reviews and hip-hop news. And today, we are going to be checking out Maxo Cream's third studio album, Weight of the World. First, don't forget to hit subscribe to Black TV for more reviews, more reactions. Hit that like button. And in the comment section below, tell me something about Maxo Cream, because I haven't heard nothing about Maxo Cream. I haven't heard nothing. I haven't seen nothing. I haven't did nothing on Maxo Cream. Put that in the comment section below and educate me on it. I just know that I know a lot of people has been telling me to do a reaction to his album, that I would love it. So I'm like, that's one of the releases of the week. So without any further ado, I know he's from Texas. I know that much. He is from Texas. And he was also on Wale's album. And I actually like that verse from him on Wale's album. If you haven't checked out Wale's album of my reaction, hit this little thing right there. Yeah. But without any further ado, let's get into this Weight of the World with track one, Crippston. I don't even know if I said that right. Come on, it's coming on with a sample. I like samples. Okay, all right, Maxo, all right.
Pray at night like Father God is there, heaven for a G. Jesus Christ could walk on water, I'm a crip walk on the sea. Dodging, drilling, making through hell, but never heaven. Getting cash, what's the motive? What a pimp nigga told me.
Now I understand why he called it Crippston, like Christian, but Crippston. I like that. I like where this song is going.
Plus my granny getting older. She got sick and caught pneumonia. Doctor said it was corona. I hope it don't coma. I can't tell her cousin Andre killed himself. He told me he gonna ride, put my brother killers in the grave.
Man, let me tell y'all something. Anxiety, depression is real. Maxo just said that his partner was gonna take out his enemies, but before he can do that, he offed himself. And I would say that I suffer from depression and anxiety too, so I'm a real big advocate of that. So if you don't really just talk to nobody and you see anybody that's even looks depressed, just say, are you all right? You good? How was your day? Sometimes that will make a person's day just that much better. All right, let me get off my soapbox.
Can't get in heaven, can I at least visit my brother? So I could tell him about my niece how much I love him. Fuck the Pope, can't trust the church, feel like they all against him.
This man said, the church and the Pope, because they feel like he, all of them dissing me. Ooh, I don't know what to say about that.
What crip niggas from the sea?
So that was track one, Crippston. And I actually like that song. I like where he was talking about how his beliefs on, you know, religious beliefs on just how he feel about it. You know, his partner taking his own self out and, you know, just people in church just talking about it. As far as the song go, the song is all right. It's decent. I like the sample in the beat. It's a good tone to where if this is the rest of the tone of the whole album, I think I'm gonna kind of enjoy it. Track two, 1159. Another track with a sample on it.
Dicks, bricks, weed, slanging on. Country ass nigga, country like Leanne Rhymes.
Country ass nigga like Leanne Rhymes. Bars.
The streets I got credit, swipe your body with a Visa. Shooting pistols like a pistol hat.
So basically that song is just like him talking about him in the street life. People that he know turn 12. Like 1159. I like that bar.
I could rap about trapping, serving nickel, slanging dimes. See niggas turn 12 like 1159.
You know, this is just a street song, you know. Just a average street song. I mean, the beat, I like the sample in it, you know. Kind of similar to the first track, but it's pretty decent. It didn't wow me, but what I'm hearing right now, I like it. Track three, They Say.
And they say Maxo a bitch. They say Maxo a hoe. He got rich and he dipped, don't come around no more. But he fuck with them 60s, you ain't no schoolboy Q. And you ain't crippin' like Nipsey, he better not come to the block. Don't rappin' too damn long. When he droppin' the album, he put Playboy Cardi on. Then that nigga surpassed him.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Did he actually have anything to do with Playboy Cardi getting on? I don't know. Y'all let me know. Because this is my first time actually listening to Matzo Cream. And I know that he's from Texas. That's all I know. From what I'm hearing, I'm actually liking it. This song right here is basically him saying what they saying about him. They saying a lot. They saying a lot. But did he have anything to do putting Playboy Cardi on? I like maybe two songs from Playboy Cardi, but I'm not a fan of that guy. So. I like it. It's screwing down.
Trenches started making rap money. Cool niggas started beat. Acting.
I love that beat switch. I love that beat switch up. I love it when, like, if it's got two fire beats, from here to there, I love it. But sometimes, majority of times, it doesn't work for artists. Drake!
Ghost died, I ain't even trying to buy some clothes for niggas. Put my cash on Instagram and post it like you stole it from me.
Man, who is he talking about? Is it somebody personal? This man said he gave him some money, then he posted it on Instagram, and he had he tell people like he stole it, like he just finessed Matzo Cream. That's messed up, bro.
I threw two foes on my Lambo, Texas 4G auto plate. I wasn't stingy with my cake. I let you.
That song right there said a lot about Matzo. I mean, of course, you're going to have haters. If you don't have haters, you're not going to be successful. That's just point blank, period. And obviously, the second half of They Say is like, you know, he's talking about a guy that basically did him wrong. Like, you got to keep your enemies real close to you because, like, man, I don't know. I've been through a lot of situations like that. And I'm really feeling this song right here because it's very relatable to me. So yeah, I'm going to say it's 3 for 3 so far. But I will say the instrumental is kind of getting repetitive. Same sample, you know, sample beat, you know, it's all right. Track 4, Big Persona featuring Tyler, the Creator. Oh, and it's a music video. I wonder how this going to sound.
Fuck these niggas talking about million for the summer high. You can't allude. Got a Grammy and that just the interlude. Y'all niggas lucky ain't spent the other two. Big shit, big money, big cars, big jewels, big y'all.
Man, Tyler's going in on it, man. Tyler going in. He had to throw that little flex in about the Grammy, man. I mean, I would too. I don't blame him. That chorus is fire, bro.
Barack Obama, Betty Crocker, used to.
I don't like the fact that his words don't sync. Like, if you don't, like, that's just a big pet peeve of mine. Like, if you're in a music video, please say your words, man. Just don't be lazy and not, you know, that's just a real big pet peeve of mine.
Late, broke ass niggas love to hate. Can't pay his rent, he always late. I left the hood, they call me.
Yo, this song right here might be my favorite so far, because Tyler, dang, that whole chorus and hook, and even Tyler's verse was off the chain. Matzo sounded all right on the song. It sounded like he was real relaxed on it. You know, it wasn't a standout as far as Tyler's was, but I mean, it was decent. The instrumental was very epic with the horns in it. That was my favorite part of it. I'm glad that it didn't have a sample in it. It came on very confusing because it switched up beats 3 times within the first 10 seconds. But overall, so far, this is my favorite song. Track 5, CC featuring Mona Leo.
Two D or my shoe. Double C my crib Chanel. We can link like URL. Looking like 12, I can tell he a tail. Nigga ass off like a pelly.
We lay them down on they back and they ass, and it's going down like a wink, no less. Drop tax, dick these nigga faked in a bitch, they plastic. My niggas pull up in hood, smelling like Creed. They moving just like assassin.
Let me tell y'all something about Creed. Creed is the top dog cologne of all time. I got some in the room right now. Like that, if you really trying to drop them draws on her, yeah, by Creed, man.
But nigga, I can't. I am that bad bitch, but I feel like the man now.
Mona Leo snapped. She snapped. She wasn't like, ooh. She was like, yeah, she all right. She straight. Yeah.
Bitch. Choppers on deck and I walk down shit like DMX and Bill.
What really stood out about that song is his flow. Like, I love how Maxo Cream flowed on that song. And Mona Leo really snapped. Like, but I will say, it just, what really just stood out is that flow. The beat was all right. It was pretty decent. Mona Leo did her thing. But what really stood out to me was Maxo's flow and cadence on that song. Track 6, Streets Alone featuring A$AP Rocky. I like his features on his album. That beat is hard. Barred, hard.
Mama praying that I leave the streets alone. Preacher praying that I leave the reef alone. Throw up my set, they get upset. They coming at me in the red.
Just take the steps. Broke my ankle, broke my toe. Ripping and stepping for my bro.
I like when rappers make a second, like, rap name for themselves. And I don't know, but Maxo Michael Myers, that kind of fixed his persona, man. Because I like that. Michael Myers. Yeah, I like that.
Daddy Yankee with that gasolina, I saw reggae thong.
Yo, what stood out about that song, A$AP Rocky on the hook? Like, this album got some good hooks, melodies on it so far. Maxo did his thing on it. A$AP Rocky, you know, did his thing. No, the song is good. It just didn't wow me. It's good, though. I'm glad that it's not a sampled song once again. Well, It got some vocals in it, but I don't know if those are sampled or not. Track 7, Don't Play With Shawty. I'm not. This beat sound like a video game or something.
Click clack, Maxo Shaq, back him down, it's a mismatch. First you got robbed, you never got your get back. Better get your gun, boy, you don't want the collar for the K. Pushing weight like a bench press.
I'm not the Corvette, nigga, I ain't done yet.
I might just take off and buy me an island. Sweet steak, hustle with the flow, pimp a hole like DJ. Walking through the city like did to get my cheesecake.
So, that shit, rap on me, I'ma kill you, bitch ass nigga. Yeah, that nigga got my name, and ain't off any of that shit, I'm still rocking.
Basically, at the end of that, he was really, like, putting a lot of threats out there. But once again, I like the flow on this song. I actually like the beat. The beat has a little techno sound to it, like a old Atari techno sound to it. Sounds different. It's different from the rest of the songs, but it actually sounds good. Basically, the song is self-explanatory. Don't play with me, play with your guy, man. That's it. Track 8, Local Joker.
Before I play that's a music tag, video. I play kick though Before I play freeze tag, I play kick though. Before I heard the word romance, I heard the on my way to sell a quarter. But it's persona that I'm serving. No more gas bag in the
I like that beat breakdown. Now I like that shot where like the camera is panning from him and his friends, like they just sitting there just vibing to the song. I like that shot for some reason. I mean, like,
when I go back to my hood, I see them same old niggas on the same old shit with them same old issues.
Basically, he just telling you that he's not no local dude. He's out here actually getting paid for what he loved to do. And, you know, I like this sound. Now, just off of what I heard off of Maxo Cream, he's like, He has a lot of Texas delivery in his voice with like an East Coast sound to him. That's very unique, like a Texas artist with a East Coast feel to him. I can't really think of anybody off the top that has ever did that out of Texas or anything like that, but that's very unique to me. I like that. I like that aspect on Maxo. Oh, man. Track 9, What I Look Like featuring Freddie Gibbs. These features, he has a good feature list on this album. I like that. That's one highlight I like. With Freddie Gibbs on this, it has to be a banger. Not have to, but I assume it's going to sound good.
Now what I look like, and if it ain't money, I don't look right. Gamble for the money, but I don't shoot dice. Shoot just like dice. I shoot once, not twice.
I just caught what he said, man. He said he shoot first, but he don't shoot dice. Ain't that what he said?
That's new ice. New G63, cut the roof, not a top back. We shooting 223s. I can't snort lines because I so crack and I don't do lines.
Don't get high on your own supply. That's A lot of people don't know that, haven't learned that lesson yet.
We've been flipping that thing, I ship it off, wrap a book tight. Nigga, this bitch of the smack, I still got crack, I got good white. 184 pounds, bitch, I'm the real skinny shit, and I keep a package in it.
Basically, that song is them talking that ish. Freddie Gibbs did a good job. Matto did a good job. This is just a song that, you know, with a sample on it. They talking that ish, you know. Had a few couple of good punchliners here and there. It's all right. It's decent. The song is decent. Track 10, For Real, For Real. Very jazzy. Jazzy sound to it.
Big coming crip like Tukey. New Jack used to serve Pookie. And I walk around with my semi. I was in the trap like Gucci. Sold more bags than Gucci. I'm in my belly, but
he said he was in a trap like Gucci. He sold more bags than Gucci. That's a double meaning, like Gucci man, the Gucci store. I know y'all know. I know.
Drip designer, bought a new Draco chopper. Had a dream about killing my partner. Niggas be fake, gotta watch them. Smiley, I'ma buy me an op, go shopping. Two bands to get me a body. One band to get me a body. 500 to get me a body.
Man, just those little two bars in the chorus makes the song. Just makes it sound that good, man. It sound like it's finna go off, but it got a whole minute left. I guess this is a live band just playing it out at the end of it. So basically, you know, that's just a song telling what would he'll do for real if people was speak on his name, come after him, and just stuff he did in the streets. What makes this song really stand out is the instrumental. I don't know if he had a live band to actually play the background on this beat or instrumental. I don't know if it's actually a live band entirely, but I like that. I like the aspect. I actually like when an artist be on stage with a live band performing their songs, but you can't really just do that everywhere where you perform. It just depends on the certain venue you're at. Track 11, Whole Lotta.
And talk my shit, I boasted and brag cause it was not supposed to last. Not even talking about rap, I'm talking bullets, drugs, or scraps. Even at your front though. I was nucking, I was bucking, serving ducking from the undo. Bunch of flunkies serving junkies, Uncle Bo was my first custom place for me. Been through the mud 100 times and still it ain't a stain on me.
That man said he been through the mud 100 times and it's still not a stain on me. That speaks a lot, man. A man can go through a lot and come out nothing damaged about him. It's hard to actually, you know, even say that. Like, I mean, even the strongest people, you know, get damaged from here to here, but that says a lot about him.
Scraps, I got members in the pen and I got members who went back to that nigga. Hope they show that nigga all of my praise.
That song was really, really short. It was really short. But, you know, once again, he's talking about his life, you know, what he been through and all that. It's a lot of him. And it's just a self-explanatory. The beat was all right. The beat was all right. Like, it was very smooth, very mellow. It was all right. It didn't wow me. Nothing really wowed me, but a couple of songs here and there. But I will talk about that towards the end of this video. But the song was all right. It was all right. Track 12, Worthless.
My black on my gat and my Rover, huh? I bought a hack in the soul catalog. Every song that I did was off Adderall. Bought a crib in that hill.
He said every song he did off Adderall. That goes back to remind me of what Lil Wayne said in that interview, that famous interview, that Moneybagg Yo sampled on Waukesha, that look like, don't worry what's in my cup. I done got all these achievements off of what's in my cup. Maybe I need to pick that cup up back again. And basically, he's saying the same thing in this song. Like, look, he stopped all his stuff, quit worrying him. But he said he did a whole album off Adderall, man. I ain't never did no drugs, so I can't relate.
No. Before I start taking Addies, I start selling Addies. Just send me your Addy, I ship them out.
Yeah, like I said before, this song is basically about him and his effects on drugs and what the effects of was him. But he said that he don't take them no more. But I mean, I don't know. I don't know the man. I like the song. I like the beat. You know, another sample beat. You know, if this is Matto Cream's niche. Put that in the comment section and let me know. He obviously love rapping on like East Coast type beats, whatever, whatnot. But I would love to hear this song, Screwed and Chopped. Like, this whole album might sound kind of good, Screwed and Chopped, personally. Track 14, Mama's Purse.
Ever since I could remember, I've been popping my collar, Jordan spending top dollar. Ever since I made some figures, I've been spurging on my mama, and that's the motherfucking problem. Still remember early mornings for them Jordans stealing out my mama purse. The way she got it, my guess was finesse. I really never knew that she was shoplifting, did it the best. My aunties did it too.
Oh, man. Like, his mom did what she had to do to make sure her kids and him was fresh. Like, they wore fresh clothes and stuff to school, not knowing his mom was stealing. And her sisters too. And that's messed up, because previously before, he said that he was stealing out of his mom's purse. And previously before that, he said that he would give the world to his mom, buy her all this stuff. But all that didn't amount to nothing, because when he found out when he was younger, you know, when she found out he was stealing out her purse, none of that mattered. He found out what she used to do for him, man, you can't tell me you just didn't feel the first minute of this song.
Faces ain't like Miss Jacqueline, cause she was always jacking them, cutting them sensors with scissors, switching the price tag on denim.
And I'm gonna tell y'all something, that little bar right there, he got that from 3-6 Mafia's Popping My Collar. If you must know.
I still remember Uncle Maine stealing chains from the offering at the church.
Oh man. His uncle was stealing change out the offering at the church. Like, man, y'all must have had it real bad if you had to steal money out the church. Like, damn.
What's even worse, after church he bought some work. You don't understand, don't say free my daddy. I could take out mug shots and make a portrait of the family.
Dan said he could take out mug shots and make a portrait of his family. It seemed like every song he's telling free his daddy. Obviously his daddy is in the penitentiary. I don't know what he did, but man, that man said he could take out mud shots and make a whole portrait of his family. That might be a dope picture though in the house if you just had that hung up and laminated, but man.
Words.
Very deep song. And like I said, this right here might be my favorite song on the album so far. I just hate the fact that I have to cut up this song so I can get even to get it played on YouTube. But this song right here, every word had a lot of weight to it. The beat was the beat felt great for the content he was saying on the song. And it's like, I know a lot more about Matto Cream just off of this song alone. Like, this song is like really deep. I sit there and I skip track 13. So we're gonna rewind and go to track 13, Greener Knots. And it's a music video. Like, I knew y'all was hollering at me in the comment section. Hold on, I'm gonna fix it.
I was thinking you would tell me.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Your friend, let me just talk to your friend. He dripped like a bird, gave you up.
Yeah.
Card.
Don't snitch, man. Don't snitch.
Yeah.
Don't do it, man.
You look like
Don't.
A good kid, man. Look at this picture. And you got a lot of potential.
Maxo, right? Look, who was in the car with you?
I don't know what you're talking about, man. What car?
Listen, man, I don't have time for this shit. And I don't have the patience for it. I've talked to all you little fuckers today and nobody knows shit. You understand me?
They got the home studio. That pulled be Maxo when he was younger.
Okay, I seen a lot. The first time I seen The Rock. Hit it right there in the chair watching WWF. First time he seen The Rock.
Oh, man. He said first time he seen The Rock. Sitting there watching WWF. I like how he do double entendres like that. I like that. Like, he was talking about The Rock. Like, Dwayne The Rock Johnson. And he's talking about the rocks that's sold in the street.
Kids, first time I seen the locks. Started getting hot, homicide. Drive by XDs, lemon squeeze, red beans, and Glock. That's what you see. Go to school, get degrees, and make the lead. But the dream not for me, so it's make believe. Block done things to my eye. Murder scene had a lease in the cops. Had the rocks, put the cheese in my socks. Oh.
You're under pressure. I get it.
Don't snitch, man.
Good kid. Don't have a big rap sheet.
What the fuck
are
you looking at, man?
What is this? Man, he look like he gonna snitch.
Answer the fucking question!
Okay, I seen a lot. Came from the slums, had to get it out the mud. No love to me, that means a lot.
So, that was Green or Knots. And, you know, the video was A1. I mean, hopefully, I don't know the conclusion of that, but hopefully, I know them guys didn't snitch. Was the guy in the Akeem Olajuwon jersey a representation of Maxo? I would assume that. But the song was very catchy, very catchy. I was waiting on Maxo to have a song that was catchy. And this is his single, Green or Knots. And I'm glad that he used this song as a, because you got to have something catchy on your album. You can't just have songs that's just a lot of you know what I mean. But good song, good video. Track 15, Trips.
July 22nd, 1992. 11 pounds, 6 ounces. Mom gave birth to money due. Instead, he fighting for his life. And he bleeding out the mouth. Breathe. I screamed, somebody help. He was in a house with came running up the steps. My brother.
So basically, that was a storytelling song telling him about what happened, how they got robbed, and everything of that nature. And I would expect a song of like Maxo Kream caliber to come out with something like this right here, because you know, if you're gonna make this kind of music, why not have a storytelling song in it? The song was decent, song was pretty good. Beat was, you know, sounded like every other sample beat on this album, but it was all right. And the last track, Believe, featuring Don Toliver. Yeah, Don Toliver. Why it sound like that? Okay.
Sippin' on the floor, I was young and bummy. As for though, they say no, they wouldn't leave me money. Had to go out and step when they catch my will. I ain't.
So that was Don Toliver with Believe, Maxo Kream. Like, I see why this is the last song. Don Toliver sound pretty good in the first half of the hook, but that beep, 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 believe. I didn't like that at all, man. Like, it started to sink in real good into that last half of that chorus. But Maxo Kream, you know, he has two short verses on here. Like, I don't know if they was like, this song will do, but I got a Don Toliver feature, so I'm just gonna throw it on the album. So that was Maxo Kream's album, Weight of the World. And I must say, I was kinda impressed, kinda. What I really like about this album is I like his cadence and his style. He's a Houston artist that's from Texas, of course, Houston, that's my God. With an East Coast feel to him, with a Houston, Texas delivery to him. And I must say, he has nice content. That's what really stood out on this album, is his content. Like me, this is my first time actually listening to Maxo Kream, but I will say I love his content. He has great storytelling, and you can tell in his delivery that he's really about that life, man. And I could tell that he's a Crip. You know, he says that in a lot. And he told a lot about his father being locked up, especially on that Mama's Purse. I will say that is my favorite track on this album, is Mama's Purse. It has great storytelling, like the beat, everything overall on that song was perfect. And I will say that this might be a contender for one of the best albums of the year, because I mean, we really haven't been getting a lot of great music lately. But I love the features on this album. That Tyler the Creator was the best standout feature on this album. You know, the worst is Don Toliver, but Tyler the Creator did his thing on this album. Mona Leo, she did her thing too. I'm not really familiar who that is, but I'm pretty sure y'all gonna tell me if y'all know who that is. Least favorite parts of this album is some of the choruses are like isn't really catchy. He doesn't have a lot of catchy stuff on this album, but to make up for that, his content as far as his storytelling and his punchlines and stuff make up for that. I just hate that he don't have a lot of catchy stuff on here. Like Greener Knots was, I would think, the most catchy song on this album, and maybe Big Persona, maybe. But I'm glad he went with Greener Knots as far as his single, cause you know, it's more radio friendly, if I could say that. Of course, my least favorite song is Believe with Don Toliver. Y'all should know that by now. I don't hate Don Toliver. I just don't like what he's just been putting in out. I like Don Toliver. I just don't like what he's been putting out. But let me go ahead and rate Mezzo Cream's Weight of the World. I'ma actually give it a high 6 out of 10. I like this album. I really do. I just don't think it has a lot of replay value, if you get what I'm saying. Just because I don't think some of the music, the stuff on the album is like, you know, is worthy of playing in the car. This is an album where you really just sit back, you to yourself with your headphones, and you just listening to them. And Mezzo might be that kind of artist. I don't know. Once again, this is my first time listening to Mezzo Cream, but I will say this is a good album. I give it a high 6 out of 10 with a few songs that will go on my library. But the most important question is, what do you think of Mezzo Cream's Weight of the World? Do you like it? Do you love it? What songs do you actually love? What songs you hate? Put that in the comment section below. Hit that like button. And until next time, I holla next time on Black TV.